What was the most uncomfortable, awkward moment you ever experienced playing Dungeons & Dragons? The dude didn't understand the premise of organized play, so he spent zero time helping with the mission and took 20 minutes to tell us about other awesome games he played instead of playing the game in front of him that ended when the store closed. I DM'd for a group where one of the girls was convinced the entire game was for her enjoyment. She would throw fits when the rest of the party didn't want to do what she did and constantly tried to split up from them. It eventually culminated in a very awkward temper tantrum when she refused to go with her party and ended up dying alone. I had the exact same thing happen, but with a dude who was like 5 or 6 years older than the rest of us playing. We're college students. DM offed him with a monster oak into the frogfish ice cream shop from the SpongeBob movie, but with a blacksmith's forge instead of ice cream. It was glorious. Playing Numenera, a role-playing game similar to D&D but taking place in the far distant future, where ancient tech is considered magic and there's all sorts of incomprehensible crap lying in trash heaps or buried in ruins. A player got a 1-time use blob of neon blue goop that, when spread on the stump of a severed appendage, grows a bright blue replacement limb. You roll a d6, and on a 1, it's half the original size, on a 6, twice the original size, any other result and it's normal. This is obviously meant to be a replacement for a lost arm or leg, with a little extra weirdness and risk to keep things interesting. So naturally, the PC cut off his own penis, smeared the goo on the stump, and grew a foot long bright blue dong. I dunno, man. Sounds like he made the right choice. I have a lot of stories, both about my players and the times I effed up, but I'll start with a short one. Player: I don't understand why no one trusts me. Me: Sneaky Pete. You're in a Game of Thrones RPG and you named your character Sneaky Pete. Like Easy Pete's untrustworthy doppelganger. Didn't know any of the guys. Had just got into college and was looking to make friends. One of the players was playing Hearthstone on his phone all the time and would half-ass his actions without even taking his eyes off the screen. The DM didn't care and was just cracking dumb joke after dumb joke and laughing to himself. One of the other players seemed obsessed with stealing everything and disrupting the narrative. This left me and another guy trying to play it semi-seriously. It was a completely cringy experience. This was my first attempt at D&D. I used to watch some of my friends play it in school but never played it, and it probably will be the last unless my friends get into it. The DM would get drunk and start hitting on me, calling me by his sister's name the whole time. I guess I sorta looked like her. This happened every time he got drunk, which was often. I had this one player who would cheat all the dang time. He would pre-roll dice until he got the number he wanted and just point at it after moving his hand like he had just rolled when his turn was up. He refused to roll up characters in front of everyone because anyone watching was bad luck. He'd constantly change his mind and switch around things on the character several sessions in because he thought the guy wasn't min-maxed enough. He insisted on keeping his character sheet between sessions, and the character would mysteriously get stronger between every session, and that's ignoring common things like using information he couldn't possibly have, by buying the module we were playing through and memorizing it, things like that. The time in question was a session we were playing in a different system, Middle Earth role playing, or some similar name. It wasn't a D20 based system. It was D100, so you'd roll 2 10-sided dice for just about everything. The DM's girlfriend, now wife, had joined for the first time. She was a very nice person, bubbly and funny. She mostly understood the rules and played along. I noticed early on that when it was her turn, she'd roll her 2 10-sided dice, and whichever one was higher was the 10-sided dice for that roll and the rest of the rolls that round. And next round she'd repeat the process, often causing the 10s and 1s dice to change between rounds. Small time cheating, but I was used to so much worse and she was being moderately discreet about it. And then the cheater called her out. He pointed out she was ensuring she always got the highest roll to start her round and it wasn't fair the DM was letting her cheat like that just because she was his girlfriend. She looks a little shocked at being caught, and hurt at how he called her out. So the rest of us started calling out the cheating we had seen that session. Oh, you mean like the time last round where you rolled until you had a 97 and just pointed to it? Didn't you just get Firebolt? How could you have so many points in it? Did you just erase the ones from Waterbolt and transfer them over? You know that isn't in the rules, right? It's funny. I don't remember you looting that magical staff with all those bonuses. DM. Can you check to see if that's really what the whim had last session? The game got a lot quieter in some portions of the table after that. Man, mind vanilla as heck compared to some of these. It was Cat P Guy. I was sat next to him. Why the frick is there always a Cat P Guy at game shops? So back in high school we had ourselves a D&D club. It consisted of myself and 5 friends. My senior year we had a new kid join us who I'm going to call Nate. Nate was a very smart, very nerdy kid who was used to doing things mostly by the book. He had a campaign he wanted to DM, and our normal DM was happy to let him. Very early on in the campaign another kid asked to join who I am going to call Joey. Joey was not very bright. I don't know if he actually had any mental disability, but it just took him forever to get crap done. He began to roll up a character, but because he was frequently late, absent, and super slow it took him probably a dozen sessions to finish. He had to change things constantly because we would be higher level, or he didn't write it down, or he lost his sheet. Every single step of character creation required one of us to basically do it for him. Eventually though, he finally finished his character, an arcane archer. Nate shoehorned him into the story by having us stumble upon him in the dungeon we were in. He was finally going to get to play with us. We left the room we found him in and proceeded to the next area. We open a door and are immediately faced with a beholder. It uses its finger of death eye on a random party member, which happens to be Joey. Joey rolls a 3 on his saving throw. Joey dies within 2 minutes of playing, having done nothing but fail to roll a fort save. Now, all of us are thinking, Nate, for the love of God, just make something up that allows him to still be alive. Unfortunately, Nate isn't physic and as I said before he is very by the book. Joey is dead, and must roll a new character. It was so unbelievably awkward and painful. We still regret and talk about the mistake of not forcing Nate to let Joey live over 10 years later. The rules exist to help people have fun, not to destroy it. These are the kind of stories I came here to read. Played one session with a bunch of people who had never played before. Most of them were cool, but one guy who was playing a wizard discovered that some low-level spell he had, prestidigitation, allowed him to clean or soil objects up to a certain size. He spent the rest of the session trying to soil everyone and everything we encountered. It was funny the first couple times but it got annoying really fast. Those kind of in-jokes can be so good in a long-term campaign. We had a bard ranger who pretty much only knew mend as his spell. So at least once or twice per session someone would rip burn their clothes in a fight, and he would pipe up excitedly, "I cast mend." Lots of fun when it happens a couple times per session. Not fun 20 times in one session. I saw a dude in his mid-20s cry and storm out of the room because his character got killed because he was doing something stupid, and he did get some bad rolls. Like a full-on child hissy fit over a D&D character death. He never wanted to play after that. Some people put a lot into their characters, stuff they're lacking I roll. My DM is a bit loose on taking suggestions on things that don't impact the campaign but make us roleplay. My dwarf was attacking some random bandit and he had to move under a beam and hit the bandit with his hammer. I rolled a 1. The DM said I ran under the beam but raised my hammer too early, hitting the beam and falling prone. To which the cleric replied and he pooped his pants. That was only the first time my dwarf shat himself. Misread that as the only time. The word first implies more shittage. Do tell. First time playing. Approx 2003. We were in a cave. My turn came up. I said, in my best George W. Bush impersonation, let's search the cave for weapons of mass destruction. I was told to leave. Went back to playing Icewind Dale by myself. That is really stupid and funny. Once a buddy of mine set me up on a date with a girl he knew. We hit it off and started dating. Turns out the buddy didn't expect us to hit it off. He was just trying to ice her a bit while he was off dating someone else. When he found out we were actually dating he flipped out. He was my DM. The next session he tried to kill my character, a Dundee second ed, LVL8 fighter. The other players wouldn't have it. It turned into a weird shouting match about betrayal and douchebaggery. Sounds like a swell guy. Hope he eventually flushed out his headgear. Well, this kinda needs a breakdown. I joined an online game with the following. Me, DM and his girlfriend, we'll call them couple 1, another couple who we'll call couple 2, some chick that the DM had I guess met on the internet at some point. I only played one session, but the gist of it is that the chick from couple 1 made it a point to flirt and try to get nasty with the solo chick or the dude from couple 2 as much as possible. The chick from couple 2 was constantly flirting and trying to get nasty with me, and the dude from couple 2 tried to get nasty with every single female NPC that the DM put out there, whether it was alive or dead. The DM kept making commentary throughout the session about how he really likes black chicks, but the only black chick at the table was the solo chick. It was just frickin' weird. It crossed into the realm of ERP multiple times throughout the entirety of the 5-hour long session, and while everyone else seemed to be having a great time, I just felt freaking out of place and weird the entire time. It was like being at a swingers party, but you are just confused as frick because you were invited to have a couple drinks and play poker. I've told this story before, but I was deployed alone to a unit I was unfamiliar with. I tried to make friends there, and one of the things the guys would do was play D&D. I had never played, but I asked if I could and they set me up. So here I am walking through a cave with literal and figurative strangers. I don't know these guys, but everyone seems level-headed. That is until I get to a cliff face that is too dark to see. I have a torch, so I light it up. Freaking crap explodes. I must have missed something because everyone turned on me. One guy got up and threw a chair. He freaking rolls to douse the torch and calls me an butthole. I'm confused, I say sorry and we carry on, but every move I made they all gave me a distrustful look. It was a long deployment and tensions were high. It was my first and last time playing D&D. A member of the party spent 20 minutes trying to seduce everything in the room. The DM wouldn't have it. He wouldn't stop trying. Freaking bards. I seduced a dragon so it doesn't always end up making things awkward. That dragon became my wife and she helped me throughout the rest of the campaign. She died protecting me. I miss my dragon wife. Some girl we were playing with insisted on having her character have sex with one of the enemies. Very uncomfortable. Whenever someone just disobeys the rules they agreed to, it's so awkward to have that conversation. I used to DM, and one of my stipulations was no evil player characters. I've just seen it led to too much in-character fighting in the past, and in-character fighting usually leads to real-life arguing, so nope. Just a rule I have when I DM. One guy agreed, then made the most evil neutral character I've ever seen. Sorry, but disguising yourself as someone, then cutting her face off while she's still alive so you can't assume her identity is evil. I don't care what it says on your character sheet, Evan. There were a lot of other evil things he did. Torture, unprovoked murder of innocents, etc. But this is where the rest of the party finally turned on him. He fought it for a while, but eventually he brought a new character the next session. You can only be neutral for so long. A DM took a comedic moment too far and basically turned an entire adventure into a send-up of the Rocky Horror Picture Show. A mysterious alchemist character who was supposed to be a recurring villain practically turned into Dr. Frankenfurter. Jokes naturally creep into a campaign, but I've always felt when you start writing them in that it can be too much. Months later, when that group had fizzled, I had an opportunity to view the DM's notes and what that adventure could have been before the jokes was something awesome. But at the same time, some of the most beautiful things in D&D happen when the players and DM both have been forced off the rails into a wild adventure for all involved. Just hope the DM pre-planned enough world building or potential diversionary content to keep things going, unless they're an absolute story master with improvisation. You have been visited by the Wall Doggo. Subscribe to Reddit on Tap and YO. You will have good luck for 2 entire weeks. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.